Hi, in today's episode, we have Moni Kumar, the co-founder of Pause. Pause was initiated by her husband and her founder, who is also her son, Akash. Pause has for very long been working with stray dogs. Pause currently houses about 14 dogs. Moni has 14 dogs in her house. These injured dogs are rescued from the street. She treats them and then she sends them back. She also tries to generally try to involve the local people and raise awareness towards these street dogs. How to take care of them, feed them, help them in neutering and adopting them. They don't have a shelter currently, but they're planning to have one in the future so that they can treat other animals too. Welcome, Moni, in today's podcast.
Thank you, Moa, for having me. I'm really grateful.
So, Moni, please tell me the incident that was really the trigger for you to get into, helping stray dogs and getting into this full-time as, your passion and something that you've been following for the last so many years. So tell me, what was that incident, Moni?
This journey started 25 years back when we shifted to Gurgaon. We had this black dog named her Kali, who gave her a litter of 6 puppies in the drain in front of her house. So at night, they used to start crying, and we got them inside home. We just had a one-bedroom house then. When my mother died, and I was just 5 years old, she had a dog. We had a dog then. And because she expired, then it was a small puppy. You could not keep him. So my father had to give it away to someone. So that was one thing which always stayed with me, that when I grow up, I will have a puppy. I always wanted to keep a puppy. So when we shifted here after our marriage, and then this girl we found in the ditch, we brought her home. Her 4 puppies were there. We tried to put newspapers at night. It was very cold. We put the heater on. And the puppies, as usual, they poop and they just make a lot of mess. So we got through that. And there was a very furry puppy with them, which I called Golu. So I decided to keep him. But unfortunately, he was stolen and we lost him. So after that, my son was born and we got into our careers and everything. So that always stayed with me. So once we got to the work and everything, now one day we were just coming back from dinner. We saw this puppy. We used to feed these dogs. So we found this puppy over there, which was just writhing in pain. One of her hind legs were broken. So we got her home, got her treated, and then we could never send her back. And we named her Cookie. So that was the trigger when we thought, so there's so many of them who need our help, and we need to do something about it. And that's how Pause was formed.
You did mention to me last time when we spoke, Moni, that dogs of Indian origin, the Indian stray is not really adopted, and most families opt for foreign breed dogs. So you could just tell me a little bit about how you intend to create momentum, about this, because I'm sure this must be a challenge, especially in the kind of work that you're in.
Absolutely. There's an ingrained on our mind that we should have a Labrador or any other well-bred dogs, because we get dogs because it should suit our status, not because we want to have a pet who loves us or we love him. So when we met these dogs, when we were feeding them, I really got attached to them. And 4 or 5 of them were in the park, and everybody objected that we should not have any dogs in the park. We can't feed them here. But as usual, I had to fight with them and stop them from saying that. And I kept doing what I thought was right. And the next challenge was to get them adopted. Because already in our mindset, we are used to these Labradors and Retrievers and a lot of the breeded dogs. The idea is to stop breeding. We also got a dog who was bred. The kind of pain the mother goes through to give birth to these puppies, every litter they are sold. And again, the mother has to go through the same process. The idea is to get these Indian puppies adopted and we stop exporting dogs from other countries who belong to a different kind of weather and region. These dogs are more resilient. They are more, if you train them, they are beautiful and they are part of your family like anything. And they're excellent security dogs.
So you telling me that actually people are, they combine their status with the dogs that they keep? This is
absolutely.
A huge revelation for me because, you know, we never looked at it like that. Because to me, a lab is a very cute looking dog. And I mean, dogs, of course, and when you look into their eyes, you see so much of kindness in the
absolutely.
Eyes. But
all the dogs have kindness.
Yes, absolutely.
So once I started feeding them.
Mm. But, you know, there's also, there is another group of people who will also talk to you about the menace that stray dogs create at times, you know. And, you know, when you're riding back at night on your motorcycle and, you know, these stray dogs often bite a lot of passerbys, you know. So how do you, you know, what do you think should be the way forward in having this whole coexistence of animal and human beings, because we cannot have a planet without the coexistence of every living organism, you know. And but this is also a fact that dogs can become a menace in many neighborhoods and also on roads when a man is walking by and a dog barks, okay, and you're scared because you're intimidated. But most people don't come across and help you because they think the dog is not powerful enough to do something to you. But you know, you can have diseases like rabies, and which is as bad as AIDS because you cannot touch water. And people die a very, very painful death. I love dogs myself, and I don't feed dogs like the way you do. But what do you think should be the coexistence of man and animal?
So we're cutting all the jungles to create more cities and growing more food for these animals which you breed and for dairy and meat. So where will these animals go? You limit them in a space that they should stay there. When they are hungry, when they are not fed, they don't find food, then they come out of that place. And that menace has been created by us, not by them. Because we are pushing our boundaries. They are not.
I agree with you. Yeah, but of course, you know, there are a lot of these bred cows also in the street who are much larger than the Indian cow, and they do
cows
cause a lot of accidents in roads, you know.
Cows are the most, exploited animal. First, their milk is taken by killing the calf, and once they are done with that, they butcher the cow or just leave them on the street.
So tell me, during this
menace is created by us, unless we stop having meat products or dairy and discourage this agriculture, animal agriculture, the government steps into it, nothing can be done.
So during this pandemic, you mentioned that many street dogs were left hungry on the streets, you know. So tell me, what was the response like when you went and spoke to people? Because I'm sure a lot of people don't have the same views like you do, you know, about, you know, feeding stray dogs, because many people can't sleep at night if a dog is barking like really late. And with the lifestyle of so many people, you know, they have little time to look after, you know, street dogs, they have little time to look after their own selves. So how did you bring about that sensitization among people? I mean, was it difficult? What did you, how did you go about it? You know, what are the kind of challenges that you faced, Moni?
I believe every human has some compassion left in themselves. Dogs are not just pets. They are also fetch dogs, and they are also used into therapy. So yeah, I agree. They create a lot of nuisance on the streets for a lot of people. So that's what happened. When I last got my dog, we named him Milo. There was too many dogs over there and they were making a lot of noise. So I saw this baby and I felt this boy will be killed if I leave him here because a lot of cars passing by. So I asked these people, that why don't you get these dogs neutered so they don't have so many babies and create a nuisance for you as well as them, which is very harmful for the mother dog as well. So I try to sensitize them, but you know how things are in India. When you want to do something good, everybody will get hold of you and stop you from doing anything about it. This lady from where I got the dog, they came to a house saying that you have taken our dog and you put him back. She took it away twice. I brought him back. And the whole community of dog, they were trolling us on Facebook for 2-3 days, saying that dog belongs to that lady, you return him back. Then we convinced them. And I'm keeping him in my house, with he's sleeping on my bed. What is the problem? What better life can he have? So this is how we kept adding our dogs, and we tried to tell people that there's nothing wrong with them. They are as good as any other breeded dogs you think. It's a difficult task. It's a mountain we have to climb. But we are trying, and we are getting a lot of responses. People are adopting indies nowadays. So that's a good thing, I guess.
Tell me a little bit about are you looking for a funding to create a shelter? Because I assume that would be the final, thing that you would look for.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right now we are feeding 150 dogs, over 150 dogs. So People say, why don't you take them home? Well, I can't keep them in my home. I already have 14. We get a lot of dogs who are injured on the road. Sometimes we send them to the hospital, which we can't handle. Sometimes we give them first aid on the road at the spot. And rest who can't be cured, we bring them home, cure them, and then send them back. So to do all this, we need a lot of funding. And there are many other animals who need help, like cats, cattle, you said, who are abundant on the road, like sheep, cats, goats. So I appeal to all these multinational who they should also look into it, and they have to come forward and help in this social, you have to participate in this social upheaval. Unless they do that, unless they take care of the environment, everything will fall apart. For that, we need a lot of funds where we can allocate places for them, we can take care of them.
So Moni, has it been very difficult for you to explain this to your friends, to your family, you know?
Yes.
Tell me your routine as to how do you go about it every day, what time do you go and feed the dogs, and do you have a car that you keep all the food in and go? You have someone to help you to do this, or you do it all by yourself?
Yeah, earlier we were just feeding 10 dogs when we started. Then I had some cervical problem. So I started going in the morning and used to go for a walk in the park. Somebody told me that Didi, somebody had given litters here. So I started feeding them at that time, around 11-ish. I get up early at 6 in the morning. Then my dogs wake me up. So we have to take them out for a walk. I have help. My husband is also helping. And I have another help who takes the dogs out. And I also take the dog out. They go for a walk. Then we come back home, feed them. Then I get ready and go with my daily chores. Then again I go around 11-ish to feed these dogs. Then I feed them, come back, and do my other work. I'm an interior designer, by the way. So take care of my office work and all. So in the evening, again we go and we feed these dogs who are on the roadside, and they are in the jungle. When we honk, then they come to eat the food. So my husband is there. He helps me. We always keep water and biscuits. And now we have started giving dog food. So my car is always full of this feed, dog feed, which can be easily carried and distributed. And some chicken and medicines. So we are always equipped. Whenever we are traveling or going anywhere, we always keep a lookout. Whenever we meet a dog, we feed them. And we can make out, once they're scurrying away, then you know they're scared and they are being they have running from their location. They don't belong to that place. So you can always make out, and we always take care of them.
So thank you, Muni, for being on this podcast today. I just want to just once again reiterate for all my listeners who are dog lovers like you and would like to get in touch with you. Muni started this about 25 years back. She has 150 dogs under her care, and she also intends to start a shelter very soon, and this can't be done alone. We need more people who are dog lovers who need to get together and collectively put this whole thing together. Muni, thank you so much for coming onto this show. To get in touch with Muni, one can give her a call. She's based out of Gurgaon. It is 98710-46201. We repeat the number again for Muni, 98710-46201. She's based out of Gurgaon. And dog lovers who are looking for more partners to get together, you can get in touch with Muni on pawsofficial.com. Thank you so much, Muni, for being on the show.
Thank you, Mawa, for having me. I am so grateful for having me over. This has been a pleasant, very pleasant conversation. I hope to carry on again.
Thank you so much, Muni. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.